Hello, everybody. Welcome back to Seat Story Cup number 5. My name is TJ, joined on the couch this time around by Radu and Chucky. So, Chucky, how you been enjoying the event so far, man?
It's going well.
Been loving it?
Yeah.
Yeah, he had a lot of time to enjoy the event.
Wow, ouch. Yeah, he's saying that you lost really early on, Chucky.
I'm catching, you know, the joke here. Mm-hmm. Red is really enjoying it.
He's giggling.
You know, we can't all go top 8.
Yeah. It's a shame. If only the whole world could go top 8.
Then no one would be top 8, TJ.
Wow, wise words. But next matchup is going to be Ecop versus Froden. This is the loser's match for Group B. So winner of this faces Naaman to see who gets out of the group. And loser goes home very disappointed because I know both these guys wanted to win a lot. Ecop said, he was just talking to us on the couch, he said, I have to win this game. And Froden just wants to prove to the world that casters are not ranked 25.
I didn't hear Ecop say that. I don't know what you're talking about. Misquoting people already, TJ?
No, he said, right there, and he like clapped his hands and did this.
I didn't see that either.
Oh. We have classes.
Yeah, guys, I don't know what TJ's talking about.
It was actually, we were on stream when he did that. Someone that's really good at lip reading could probably go back.
Lip reading?
Look at the VODs, watch him do this.
Yeah, let's hire James
Bond. You want to make a bet?
And read his lips.
No.
It would have to be someone who's an expert on reading lips in the English language, but with a German accent. I wonder if that's a thing.
Does the accent matter when you read lips?
Yeah, it really does.
For what?
I don't know. I'm going to have you guys say certain phrases, and then I'm going to look at your lips and see if it changes.
Okay.
Say the word soda pop. Chucky first. I have to get a baseline.
Wait, why me first?
Soda pop.
Why am I the baseline?
Okay, Artie, you say it. Soda pop.
Soda pop.
See? Those are Romanian lips right there.
We don't even need anything.
All right, Chucky, go ahead. Soda pop.
I'm not going to succumb to peer pressure.
Well, I can already tell you that RDU's was
you
different.
You say soda pop.
I said it 4 times.
There, I just said it.
Oh, my God. But, yeah, so point proven. Thanks, RDU. But
so I didn't say anything.
Bands are in.
I said soda pop.
Yeah, and I said soda pop 4 times, and I have an American accent, so.
Okay.
All right, Froden versus Ecop. Froden banned the warrior away, and Ecop went ahead and banned the shaman.
Yeah. I definitely think Ecop should have banned the shaman. He was kind of asking people their opinions on it. My opinion was to ban shaman. I certainly wish I would have against Gaara, but at the time I didn't know what type of shaman it was.
Bulk champ is too good. I also like ban it against Just Saiyan. That was like the only way I could have won. Like, their lineup is just, like, very insane in the current meta. Just beats all the meta decks.
Yeah. And you beat Just Saiyan on the B stream earlier, right?
What?
You did? You beat Just Saiyan?
Yeah. I beat him on the B stream, but probably nobody saw it. Tomorrow when I play my top 8 game, they'll be like, who is this guy? I didn't see him.
Oh, well. You're the sleeper up pick, man. Yeah, for those of you watching, there is a second stream where... groups happen simultaneously. So, like, during breaks, you can head over to watch that one. I believe it's Tick TV.
It's Tick TV Black.
Black, yeah. But, yeah, this matchup, it's Druid versus Control Warrior that Froden's bringing.
Is it Control or is it K'Thun? I think it's Control, yeah, because of the Doomsayer, right?
K'Thun.
Yeah. The classes on Froden's side just change the Shaman to Warrior. A little
bit
wrong
right now.
I don't
know. I think it's K'Thun.
Is it K'Thun?
I just think so.
K'Thun Warrior can run Doomsayer?
Yeah, why not?
Okay.
Anything can run Doomsayer. It's a neutral card, TJ.
Wow. Good one. Real clever.
That's not a joke. Anyone can.
Do you play it in your Zoom as a 2-drop?
I mean, no.
Why not? It's a neutral.
Well, I could. I just choose not to. That's the freedom of choice, Radu.
Can you really afford...
Something you might not know here in Europe.
All right, let me...
Wow.
Let me...
what?
Whoa.
Get some USAs in the chat. All right, it's K'Thun.
Yeah, you're going to have a lot of freedom next year.
No, Bran is a neutral.
Well, Cthulhu's a neutral, too. All right, until he sees Ancient Shieldbearer, TJ is in suspended belief.
Until I see Cthulhu. Which means any Cthulhu buffer also, because they'll show Cthulhu.
What if it's a bug? What if there's no Cthulhu?
Oh, God. Then what?
I don't know.
Who's favored in this matchup?
I would say the Druid, like, usually...
No, go ahead, Artie.
I would say that the Druid is usually picked up to beat the Warriors, but it struggles versus Dragon Warrior. But Frodan is not playing Dragon Warrior, so the Druid should be able to take this home.
Yeah, I disagree.
Because?
Because Bran is a neutral.
You know, I don't really have a reason. I just disagree.
Nice. Freedom of speech, right? You also have that in America.
I don't know. Depends on Ecop's Druid build here. All we've seen are spells.
Druid of the Claw is an interesting choice. Like, a lot of people have opted to cut it from their Druid lists.
Ooh.
In favor of, like,
these
some
are
other midrange cards.
Jessicar, Trueheart.
Jessicar, do it.
Yeah, I think Jessicar's the best. That's going to add up to a lot of damage over the course of the game.
No, you don't take Jessicar. Let's get real here.
You take Illidan?
Illidan? Yeah, yeah.
Yeah. I mean, that's
the
other choice.
Who was it saying earlier Illidan was really good in?
They didn't say it was really good. They said just you could use it.
Yeah. Because it is a neutral.
You know, Hearthstone Heroes of Warcraft is a very strategic game. And I'm glad we know all the nuances here on the analyst couch.
Same.
It's a very awkward situation for Frodan. He needs to kill the board, but he doesn't really want to invest anything that much into killing it. I think it's just Shield Slam and probably armor up, leave the 3-3.
Yeah, because you can clear the 3-3 with Ravaging Ghoul, Disciple of Cthulhu next turn.
All right,
and
guys.
You can also kill...
I have an idea.
But you can also kill the Druid of Call with Bran, Disciple of Cthulhu next turn.
Oh, wait a second. Disciple of Cthulhu tells us it's Cthulhu Warrior, right?
Yeah.
Well, it could be Cthulhu-less Cthulhu Warrior.
Cthulhu-less?
Like you could just be using it to buff the Shield Bearers and not play the Cthulhu.
So you play the handicap...
No, you can't do that because you're...
You can do that. It works. It just doesn't visually show it. I know
this. You tested this before?
Nostum did.
Oh.
He tested Cthulhu-less Cthulhu Mage.
Wow.
It was not good.
Wow, how surprising. Tell us why, Chucky.
I don't know.
Do you know anything?
Yeah.
Like?
I don't know.
Okay.
So, what if Ecop finds the second Raven Idol? Raven Idol's a minion again, hits Finley, gets armor up, and gets tank up before Frodan.
No, I think you get the upgraded shapeshift.
No. If you change with Finley, I know this.
Why do you know this?
Because I have tanked up to 130 armor as a hunter before.
Huh.
It's
I didn't
on
my know
Twitter.
That.
You can follow me at @Chalky_HS. Smooth transition to the plug.
Or you could not. Or you could follow G2RDU.
Or you could follow @AzumoCutie.
Wow, I didn't even have to plug myself.
Very, very well done.
But if it's the other way around, like if you play Jessicar and then Finley, you go back to your original hero power.
Yeah.
We need these guys' toast to like help us here.
It's Cthulhu Warrior.
So it's Cthulhu Warrior. It's not Cthulhu,
yeah,
it's Cthulhu Warrior. Okay.
For sure.
Nice.
Glad we made that clear.
So he's just playing Doomsayers in Cthulhu Warrior. That's interesting.
It's not that out of this world. I mean, he's banning Warrior, so like... It sort of makes sense that you don't need to be as greedy with the list. You can kind of be more anti-aggro.
Yeah.
So put in cards like Doomsayer, try to win more against Shaman and Zoo, which are two of the decks he left open for Ecop.
Probably like cuts up Beckoner Beeble.
Yeah.
Just runs one or maybe not even any.
Yeah, I think one is the more popular build right now.
You just mulligan for War Axe and Doomsayer instead of like Beckoner Beeble.
Yeah, Beckoner Beeble's not even that great as like a minion, it just serves to proc the
more consistent
the Cthulhu cards.
Yeah. Yeah, it just gets traded way too easily. It's kind of like a Darknassus that doesn't even incentivize the opponent to kill it.
All right. Most likely you're just going to see the coin swipe.
Yeah, it's a pretty solid swipe. I'm surprised Frodan just opted to play the Bronze so early. That can tell us that he doesn't play Emperor and Doomcaller, because usually you want to keep it for that synergy.
Well, that's really probably not going to happen this game, even if he did run those cards, but I would agree that he probably doesn't have those. But, I mean, his hand was kind of forced. Like, he had no great answer to the 4-4 on the board, so just got to make use of the cards you have, not try and get too fancy and play for the late game for that extra 10 armor or anything. It doesn't really matter if you keep letting a 4-4 hit you.
I think you have to drop Justicar here. It's not really good, but you have to.
He could go Acolyte Ghoul.
Acolyte Ghoul, and next turn you can Justicar and fit in a tank up.
I don't know. Maybe.
But he has to play Acolyte of Pain and Ravaging Ghoul, according to RDU.
Wait,
no, he has to play Justicar.
Oh.
But he didn't. You said he has to.
Great analysis, Radu. Why are you even here?
Because he made it through groups. He has nothing better to do.
Fair enough.
It's better than not making it through groups and have nothing better to do.
That's debatable.
I mean,
I've been laddering today with C'Thun Rogue, and it's been a fun time.
Yeah, I bet you enjoyed yourself.
Yeah.
Nice.
I C'Thun someone for 74.
Thank you for sharing.
You're welcome.
I appreciate.
You know.
Okay, going back to the game. Easy time for Justicar from Ekop.
Yeah. Wow.
Justicar, rough trade.
It's a bold call there, considering he's hovering over it.
I mean,
I don't know.
Do you think I don't have my own opinions?
He might go for it. Welcome to the Bronze Tournament Champion. There it is.
Frodan gives himself a little giggle.
An Ailey giggle, or just a giggle?
That was just a regular giggle.
Not nice. So now do you play Justicar? I really want to see Justicar being played faster.
You can fire Warx and Justicar this turn.
Or you could not.
But I mean, there's no point in playing Justicar if... Well, I guess that's wrong. I was going to say there's no point in playing Justicar if you're not going to fit in armor ups anytime soon. But I guess it gets the 6-man out of the way.
Yeah, you get the 6-man out of the way, and when you'll have the 2-mana empty, you just cash in on that better hero power.
Yeah.
Are we going to see Yogg? Like, if Ekop is in a very favorable situation, he might just not need to play the Yogg-Saron.
Well, I feel like you have to beat out a lot of removal before you play Yogg-Saron in this matchup.
Okay.
Like, you play it as... But I don't know, because if you play it as a last-ditch effort, then a lot of times it won't win you the game. Warriors can stabilize pretty easily, even after Yogg. But you have to see a lot of removal first before anything.
Or you could just jam it this turn.
By the way, fast question. What is the name of the hero power of the druid?
Pop
quiz.
Oh, man. It's...
Come on.
Wait, the upgraded one?
I believe it's like something of the pact. Of the pack.
Wait. Dire Shapeshift.
No, Dire Shapeshift.
Sap the casters. Yeah. Please.
Shift up. Dire Shapeshift. Pay attention,
class. Good thing that wasn't a question at the Archon House Cup.
Yeah, maybe you wouldn't have won your only tournament.
Whoa.
Didn't even win the Master of Duels.
Since then, I picked up a second win.
Oh, yeah.
Not even near as challenging. I mean, Trivia was much harder.
Why isn't Justicar played in more druid lists?
Yeah,
don't laugh at me.
The Dire Shapeshift.
I mean, it is a neutral card.
Easy, Chucky. Easy.
Because you can... Like, 2 armor and 2 damage makes your trade so much better. If you're playing a slower druid deck, why not?
I mean, I'd rather play the Frost
answer.
Elemental. I would rather play the 6-mana 5/5 that freezes something than play Justicar.
To explain it in the layman's terms to you, TJ, Thanks. It's not played because there are 30 cards that are superior to it within the Druid class.
There's got to be something that you can cut.
There is something you could cut, but no one chooses to do it.
Like an Azure Drake.
Something like an Azure Drake.
What about something like Feral Rage?
I mean...
Because you get the armor back if you armor up, if you use the hero power eight times.
Yeah, but you also get the damage back if you use it only twice.
Yeah, thinking of the long
term. And you're not even thinking about the 6-3 body.
No. It's only plus one damage. You have to use it four times.
You can play the swordsman that allows you to use it twice per turn.
The swordsman.
I forgot his name. Nobody plays with that card.
What is that card even called? It's not a swordsman.
It's a 2-mana 2/3.
Yeah, I know. It's Garrison Commander.
Garrison Commander. Yeah. He has a sword.
No, he doesn't. He's a swordsman.
Well, you would say he's not the swordsman. Well, he clearly wields a sword in the picture. Are you just insulting the art, the guy that made the art?
I just think he's not that good with a sword. I don't even know if there's a sword in the picture. I don't believe you.
He's going to Google it.
I am.
The issue is that he has a sword and he only has 2 attack. That's pretty lame, right?
Right. Obviously, he's not that great with the sword.
Maybe he's more at defending with the sword.
Golshire Footman has a sword. He's only 1 attack.
Okay.
Target Dummy has a sword and it's 0
Golshire
attack.
Footman doesn't actually have a sword in the art, does he?
It's implied.
It's kind of implied, yeah.
Target Dummy has a sword.
Yeah, he does.
The Shieldbearers are really powerful here. Like, just save Frodan.
Yeah.
They give him, like, a lot of health. I wonder if playing Bran was correct from Frodan, because he could have cashed in for, like, 20 now if he would have kept the Bran.
Yeah, he just didn't want to leave that 4-4
well,
up and hitting him.
No, his C'Thun activators wouldn't even be active if he didn't play the Bran.
Oh, yeah. Never mind.
Yeah, I mean, the Bran Zap play me. Was... He kind of had to do it.
I'm going to shadow... How was that spell called? Is he going on a spell rogue?
I believe it's called
Shadow Step.
Yeah, Shadow Step. I'm going
to
Shadow Step myself.
I said the wrong name. I mean, it's called Shadow Leap.
I only know the name of the good cards. I have a good visual memory,
Shadow
though.
Shadow Walk?
I have a very good visual memory. I know the pictures of all the cards, but I cannot remember the names.
He does remember cards, so just give him the wrong name. You should have called it a Garrison Swordsman.
What do you take off this right now?
Aviana.
Okay, well, stream can't see. So it was Aviana, Iron Bark Protector, and the third one was...
Naga Sea Witch.
Naga Sea Witch.
They're all interesting. Aviana is clearly better than Naga Sea Witch.
Yeah.
But he also takes the Iron Bark because he's big.
I like the Iron Bark, honestly. I don't know. Aviana didn't make much sense to me.
Yeah, it just allows you to fit a Sylvanas out on the same turn, which is not even what you want to do.
Or maybe Yogg.
Okay.
Why not? I have no time for games. Yogg is the answer to everything.
Yeah.
Frodan's C'Thun's getting pretty buff.
Well, I see the play. I see the play. You play Sylvanas, hero power the 4-2, a trade with the 2-2 into the 4-2, innervate Mulcher, own Sylvanas, steal his Sylvanas. Good game, well played.
Come up with that all on your own?
I saw it. Just
you saw it in his visions.
Yeah, I hear voices in my head. They talk to me, they understand.
They also have a Romanian accent.
But what if Mulch gives your opponent the Black Knight?
Then you still have the Sylvanas, which trades 101 with the Black Knight.
That's
what if it gives him something better?
Like another Sylvanas.
Another C'Thun? Yogg?
Yogg, yeah.
Yogg is the answer
Yogg
to everything.
Yogg in a double mind control.
It looks like he's going for the play.
Then you just feel like a dummy.
It took him way too much time. I saw it in a second. I'm just joking.
He was just thinking about it.
I'm just joking. At this level, every player wants to like, double check, triple check.
Don't want to end up executing your own Sylvanas. Yeah.
This is not a ladder game. It's a high-end tournament game.
Yeah. Well, let's see what he gets.
The Black Knight? No.
Dire Wolf Alpha. Goes well with the Dire Shapeshift because he gets killed by it.
Haha. Nice one.
Thanks, RPU.
Well, let's go ahead and throw a C'Thun. E-cop's away, I guess.
How big is it?
12-12.
That's pretty bad, right? Like, you never want to play Kutun into Sylvanas. But you have nothing better to do.
What's your alternative here?
You can attack with the face, execute it, play Kutun's Chosen and Dire Wolf Alpha, hero power, and then he trades Sylvanas. And if you get rid of the Sylvanas, you can play the Kutun and then just force your opponent to Yogg and then hope his Yogg is bad and then win the game.
Yeah, that is the actual play.
Yeah. Only play that makes sense. He does have to tank 8, but he does have tank up, so...
Take it like a man, Froden.
He'll go down to 11, go back up to 15. Not really any choice, though.
Not gonna hit it?
What? I think it was good to hit it, right?
Doesn't really make much sense to me to not hit it.
Maybe he's trying to encourage the trade into the 5-2 to steal the Direwolf Alpha, and then so he can play Cthune for free.
Yeah.
Not for free, but
yeah, but then
to.
He can execute.
Maybe he's playing for the top deck Brawl. If Brawl is his exact next card and his opponent overextends, then he can Brawl and kill the survivor with Axe Execute.
Yeah. Launched a rock.
Yes, you did, TJ.
It's pretty fun.
He keeps Tenagus and Yogg, which is probably nice. You don't want to overextend into a possible Brawl. And now Froden can execute if
and
he wants.
He can't. Yeah, he can, but none of these cards are good to play into Sylvanas. I mean, I guess the Twin Imps are okay because you have to have something extra to like kill your own Sylvanas.
Well, at this point, he wants the Sylvanas dead at whatever cost. He just needs to get Cthune onto the board. He's seen Mulch, so... I mean, if he can get Cthune down, it's basically his only chance at winning.
All right.
And we can see it's kind of awkward for Free Cup here.
He gets Anargus and buff the minions.
Yeah, then your opponent gets to kill your Sylvanas cleanly. And... yeah, it's just kind of awkward.
You think he cops has made the read that last card's Cthune?
Yeah.
Like, what else can it be?
Well, it could be any neutral card or any warrior class card.
Can it be Doomsayer?
It could be. Doomsayer is a card that can be placed into a warrior deck and kept in the hand.
Interesting. Today I learned...
I would have kind of hoped you knew that, but fair enough.
You got me, Chucky. Is there any world where you make the taunts?
Here's what I like. I actually like the taunts.
Okay.
Yeah. So here's why. If that last card's Cthune, your opponent has to go punch a taunt, and then even if he kills your Sylve before playing the Cthune, you get to steal... at least a 4-4 taunt. Or actually, no, at least
no,
a 4-1 taunt. Yeah.
You just give him the 4-1 and play Cthune, that's the play.
Yep.
Because Cthune is very likely to kill the 4-1 and the 3-1, and there's going to be Cthune versus Scenarios, and even if Cthune loses the 5 versus the mighty Centaur, or whatever the heck Scenarios is, then Doomcaller is going to bring Cthune back.
He is a mighty Centaur, that's correct.
Scenarios is pretty buff.
Especially the golden one.
It's a big dude.
Or he can just kill everything.
It. Woo!
Okay. Woo. Well, now it comes down to y'all.
Old gods,
yo, GG.
Who wins?
Stay tuned. Hearthstone, Heroes of Warcraft.
Dan knows. Ancestral healing. That's not good.
How many spells were casted? Oh, the warrior one. Oh, he only needs Justicar.
Just got a directly worse hero power. Oh, there's the taunt! Oh!
What's it gonna hit?
Oh, unlucky.
Another one.
Another one.
And another one. Now he has to kill him. That does nothing. That does nothing. Quick shot.
Oh!
Uh-oh. blood loss.
That doesn't really help, though, like the temporary freeze, unless he shatters it.
Yeah. And that's it. And that's probably a win for Dan. I don't think there's any way that Ecop can do this.
Yeah. I mean, unless he plays second mulch, and even then, it's going to be a tough road to recovery.
Yeah.
Staring down at 7-9.
Okay, you...
There's no way you Thunder Bluff. Huh?
Oh, okay, so maybe he's thinking if it's Freezing Trap.
Or Misdirection.
Okay.
Oh, yeah.
Ooh.
Yeah, I guess we have the casting insight.
So you play as many things as possible, I suppose.
Yeah.
And,
He also played around Snipe.
Okay, so Ecop actually can survive because Frodan, I think, is more likely to play around Freezing Trap than he is Bear Trap.
What was the trap?
It's Bear Trap.
Okay.
So if you kill the 2-3... And then Frodan might attack in with the 3-6 first. See, this way you never win. I mean, you're not going to win, but I don't know.
Yeah.
If you kill the 2-3, he's pretty likely to miss attack.
And then how would you win?
What?
Would you magically deal 16 damage?
I mean, maybe he just pulls the second Yogg out of his sleeve.
Doesn't work like that. Yogg is already like the Hail Mary of the Druid deck.
Do you even know what a Hail Mary is, or do you, in its actual context, they use it in?
Yeah, the last ditch effort.
Yeah, but what's the original usage?
What's the origin?
I mean...
Can I get a definition?
Use it in a sentence.
Chuck is the American guy. He can tell us.
We're asking you.
I'm American, too.
So, no. The answer is no.
Do you have you watch any American football?
No, we watch football here.
That's what I said.
Yeah, we watch football too.
Okay, so, well, do you know anything about American football? Like how to score and things like that?
No, I have no idea.
Yeah, okay. Let me try and switch over the term Hail Mary to European football. It's when there's only 2 seconds left in the game.
Well, the goalie has never 2 seconds left because of extra time.
Okay.
You never know when
the game's going to end. You can't even make the analogy anymore. Okay, pretend like in soccer, there can only be 2 seconds left.
Whoa, soccer what?
Football. Pretend in football, there can only be 2 seconds left. You give the ball to your goalie, and your goalie tries to make a goal from his own goal by throwing it.
It doesn't work like that.
That's the closest analogy.
You would need the guy from the Fantastic Four to score a goal like that.
And then his teammate catches it in the end zone or the goal in this case.
You would need the guy from the Fantastic Four to throw that ball.
That's the best way I can explain it. That's a Hail Mary, RDU.
Thank you very much for the analysis.
Okay. Game two. Got a lot more analogies to go.
Well, Ecop's throwing out the zoo, and Dan might be able to go all the way with this C'Thun Warrior. C'Thun Warrior's just been getting rolled all tournament long.
Yeah?
It has been. But Dan has a Brawl.
And the Doomsayer, the neutral card.
Yeah. And Brawl has been the one card that's been missing from the C'Thun Warrior's hands that have gotten wrecked.
Hmm.
Do you think he's playing one or two Brawls?
Two.
Like, I know like Life Coach was saying that Brawl is like very overcosted in C'Thun Warrior. And it could even be 4 mana and still not be like that great. But then you'd use it to Sylvanas. That'll never happen, but...
I think with Dan's strategy, he's leaving up Warlock and Shaman.
I think there's 3 Brawls.
Chuck, you're in timeout.
Chucky, can you explain us how you can play 3 off of one card? This is not Yu-Gi-Oh! You cannot, like, just...
Dan isn't beyond going above the rules.
I don't even know what that means. Well, one card that Warriors struggle to deal with is Darshar Councilman without Execute. So this is getting a little bit hairy.
Why'd you raise your eyebrows when you said that?
Because my eyebrows are hair.
Wow. Them American jokes. I'm too European to understand them.
Same.
What do you do here?
Probably play a card, the buffs C'Thun in some way.
Yeah, but Beckoner of Evil plays off curve.
It's better to play off curve.
Bad.
It's better to play off curve than to like just
do nothing.
Yeah, just give Darjan Squire massive value from killing your free mana guy. Disciple of C'Thun.
So this matchup's actually pretty tough because as the Zoo Warlock, you have to sort of balance like what cards to play around and when you have to just forget about everything and start throwing everything on the board.
Yeah, I like going face a lot in this matchup.
Yeah.
But playing around Brawl, like, you go face a lot and you'll try to, like, apply pressure while still having some backup plan. And usually it's better if the backup plan is not Forbidden Ritual because that plays into the Ravaging goal. So it's better to like play Ritual to pressure first and then have like some minions to play after he brawls or Ravaging Ghouls. That's like the ideal situation.
Yeah.
Is Abusive or Flaming better? You could play Flaming and trade with the Councilman, but do you want him damaged? Probably not.
Yeah. Especially since last turn you didn't really check for execute because he was only on 3 mana. So that messes up like Ravaging Ghoul execute, messes up Disciple of C'Thun execute.
Yeah, Ravaging Ghoul is insane, but he doesn't have the execute to make his turn completely devastating for Ekop.
Yeah. I think you still play it though.
Yeah, you play it over the C'Thun's Chosen.
Oh.
C'Thun's Chosen gets traded so easily on board. I don't like this that much.
He's going to brawl.
Yeah, but now Echo can just play it safe.
He can just
start by tapping, right?
Attack. Yep.
Yeah, trade and then tap Peddler probably.
Yeah.
You're like, oh, you want to brawl?
Go
Take
ahead.
My Peddler. Go ahead, yeah. Have my Flaming to just refuel.
Then maybe Dan won't brawl. Maybe he's 2 steps ahead.
But then if he doesn't brawl, he just dies. Councilman keeps growing with the power of the people, getting all the voters.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's how he grows, with the power of the people, right? Like, look at the picture of the card.
It is. The buff is indeed called.
I'll look at it on the
power
on the one
of
where
the
it
people.
Actually shows up. I'm not seeing anything here.
Power of the people, the second one. Increased attack.
It looks like a dictator to me. He's sacrificing the people's will to grow. I think that's a more accurate representation.
Yeah, he's evil.
Yeah.
Is he a politician or is he... He has a finger raised.
Let me get it again real quick.
He looks very imposing.
Very nice draw for Frodan.
Does he have a double... does he have a double chin? Or do I see...
All right, well, no, we can't see it anymore.
Okay. Rip.
And Bran Ravaging Ghoul is something that exists.
Yeah, I mean, you damage your own Bran in the process down to a 2-2, but if you clear the board in the process, then it's actually really solid. It's like a not-as-good Corrupted Seer.
What? What is that card?
What it's called? Corrupted Seer? The 2-3 Murloc that is 6 mana, that when you play it, it does 2 damage to all non-Murloc minions?
Nah, I don't know what you're talking about.
Is that card even in the game?
Yes, it is.
Are you, like, leaking new cards?
Oh, my God.
Fired. Banned. Imprisoned.
God, this is going to be on Reddit tonight.
Is it called something different?
I don't know.
It's Corrupted Seer. Or is it Cold Light? No, Cold Light Seer is worse. You're making me second guess myself.
There's so many shitty cards that we don't know.
Find.
No, Bran Ravaging Ghoul is like a worse version of it. There was
sure
a guy that was in prelims that played it all the way to like top 32.
I don't know what you're talking about.
It was Bloody Face, wasn't it?
Like, people don't even remember who got second in prelims. And you want us to remember who got top 32?
Well, nobody gets second in prelims. That's why you don't remember.
Whatever regionals. Yeah. You got me.
Semantics.
I'm still wondering what this new Murloc card is.
Google it. I'm done with that subject.
All right, I'll Google it.
Well, this is kind of weird. Ekop's entire hand is one drops, except for the Direwolf Alpha. That's not really what you want, because you want to sort of space out your threats in this matchup so you don't play too far into Brawl, but it's almost impossible to space out threats when you only have run one drops.
Yeah, I like killing the... He could have Wreathed and killed a 3-3 and then like set up a Voidwalker, Direwolf Alpha.
Yeah.
But that's very risky because leaving Bran on board is something that you don't want to do. I like this play too. This way you'll pick up the 3-2 after he kills your Voidwalker.
Yeah. That's actually a really good pickup. Fire War Axe. Just fire War Axe and use Disciple of C'Thun in value trade.
Yeah. You use the fire War Axe on the Abusive though, right?
Wouldn't you use...
You Disciple of C'Thun one of the Flame Imps, and you fire War Axe the Abusive Sergeant.
I was thinking you would fire War Axe the Voidwalker, Disciple of C'Thun one of the Flame Imps, and trade the Ravaging Ghoul into the 2-1. So you take less damage on your face, you still leave up a Flame Imp, and you still leave up your Ravaging Ghoul.
Yeah, I don't mind that either. That's worse to Juggler, but not by that much.
Yeah.
I think it was okay.
Seen one Juggler yet?
Yeah, we have seen one Juggler.
Yeah. But I mean, I guess he's tapped a lot, so... Yeah.
It's one health.
Yeah. And you save yourself one health in the process.
You save yourself one health, but you lose one health on the Ravaging Ghoul.
Yeah. Well, there's Forbidden Ritual. And Verdant's got both ways to deal with big boards. He's got the Ravaging Ghoul, and he's also got the Brawl.
Just goes face.
Yeah, so he's going to be slightly punished here. And Verdant's...
Ooh.
Got the finish line in his sights here for game number 2. And Chalky's still working on that Google. Corrupted Seer.
Yeah, that's a pretty good Ravaging Ghoul. I'm not finding anything on Corrupted Seer. I'm going to be honest.
Oh my god. Someone help me.
I'm still looking.
Nobody around knows what this card is? Anybody? Now I'm like second guessing myself. All right, well, meanwhile, Frodan takes game 2 and one game away from moving on to the decider match.
Frodan seems very happy. He's like punching his...
Frodan gets hype, man.
Yeah, he goes...
He wants to win.
I've said it before and I'll say it again. Frodan is one of the most competitive people that I know. And... he's got like more drive to win than some of the players here.
Well, I mean, he doesn't compete that often.
Yeah,
like it's a big deal to him.
Yeah, and he's been prepping. He's been focusing on his matches, so it's really cool to see him have some success. Ekop though,
Ekop has been trying too a lot recently.
Yeah. Yeah.
People underestimate how good he is.
Yeah, he took a break from like competitive play for a while. It was like a year ago, something like that, where he didn't really appear in much tournaments. He didn't really gather many championship tour points. But yeah, he's been prepping super hard. After his match that he lost earlier, he was back on a computer, pretty much just practicing, watching VODs, making sure that he was prepped for this match. So both these guys, and the winner will move on to face Naaman in the match. And Naaman actually beat Ekop earlier. That was a close series. Actually came down to a Yogg game.
Two Yoggs.
Yeah.
One cop.
Jardy was so happy about himself.
Frodo is considering not coining out the Fire War Axe.
He's
That's
not
greedy.
Just
That's really greedy.
He didn't.
Really greedy.
Well, Taunt Totem would be the punish.
Punish him!
Nope.
Never punished.
Vernon's nope. Like shaking his head. Yep. I'm the best.
Yeah, that head tilt. Slightly back and forth.
I mean, I kind of like his logic, though. He knows that he would have had no play to follow it up. Your opponent has to have, like, Totem Golem for you to be really sad. And even then, I think it's still better to have not coined it out. Because now we can play a 3 on curve, save the coin.
Yeah. But, I mean, Ecop's not looking like he's in the best position. He's got 2 Flame Wreath Faceless, but...
Yeah,
you do need to have an early game in this matchup.
Those can do some work, though.
Yeah.
I don't know about this play.
I like it.
It was way better to Hero Power if you knew you're going to get downed. So now you have to, like, evaluate the chance of getting downed and how bad of a spot you are in if you don't get downed compared to how you are on average by playing the Flame Tongue Totem.
Could you say taunt again?
Taunt. Okay. How did I...
No. Perfect.
Okay, thank you.
Beautiful.
I'm learning English day by day with Keaton Chucky Gill. Is it Gill or is it Jill?
It's Jill. 100% it's Jill.
I don't even know of a funny way to pronounce your last name.
Mine?
Yeah.
It's not.
I know. I don't have a comeback.
You just like change letters. Change the R to an E. Sandy's. It's the only way I could think of.
That sounds like a bad restaurant or something like that.
Some restaurant named Sandy's is going to sue you now.
Hey, you guys want to go to Sandy's after the cast tonight? I love their burgers.
I don't know why people in the room started clapping for this Doomsayer because
they know it's a neutral card they can put in the deck.
Frodan is not playing Freeze Mage, so there's no Frost Nova to go with his Doomsayer into healing the board.
Yeah.
The Doomsayer has no way of surviving.
And there's no Execute as well, so that would be the perfect card in this situation to use. But doesn't have it, and doesn't have a way to buff C'Thun up again to activate these Ancient Shield Bears.
That's wrong.
Once he gets to turn 7.
He does have a way to
buff
them up.
Well, Doomcaller, yeah, but not before turn 7.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. Frodan can try something here. He can play Ravaging Ghoul and then lift the coin from his hand, making Echo think that it's executed. Maybe Echo concedes. What was that, 1%? I don't know. Lift the coin fast. Nah.
Yeah, just point the coin at it. Alternatively, he could just disconnect Ecop's monitor.
No, there's actually a glass wall separating both.
Yeah, you just break the glass.
Where it just runs through the glass.
He's a competitive guy. He got the taunt. What are the chances?
10 out of 10 accent, Chucky.
Coin Emperor.
Emperor, another neutral card.
Yeah.
That he is allowed to play in his deck.
Mm-hmm.
Really good deck choice.
Is Coin Emperor really good, though?
No.
It dies.
But it's what he has.
It's better than everything he has. Everything else that he has.
Yeah. That Flame Rift Faceless is getting it for 7 again, though.
Yeah, yeah. The Flame Rift Faceless is a pretty good card. People just call it Flame on a 7-7, but we here, intelligent casters, we call it Flame Rift Faceless. I love pronouncing the name of this card. I can do it all day.
That's what we do.
Can you say that, Chucky?
Now, the Flame Rift does not have taunt.
It can.
How?
If your opponent plays Sparring Partner.
I feel like an easier way would just be the Shaman spell, Ancestral Healing.
Yeah.
All right, so...
How much damage is that?
16.
Okay. If you had one more mana, it'd be 18.
I
quick math lesson with TJ.
I think I'm okay with two lines here. You either fully ignore it or you...
All in?
Yeah, just... Well, fully ignoring it, I would just throw down the Flame Wreath, go all face, and hold back the Lava Burst. And the other play would probably be Lava Bursting it and just playing the Flame Tongue. Let's see how much this pushes. Pushes 13, so he puts him to 6. So he's a little out of range of Lava Burst if you played like Brawl.
Something like a Brawl?
Yeah, something like Brawl.
Yeah. Like Revenge?
Yeah.
Ah, yeah.
But he doesn't play Revenge because of a Doomsayer, another neutral card.
Well, he could play both.
And Revenge is a class card. He's not a neutral card, unfortunately.
Well, yeah. Froden's going to intently stare down his monitor.
Wait, what?
As he comes to the realization he is dead.
It's a ghost mouse. Jesus.
Yeah, that's...
I'm not touching it. It's doing that.
I think it's Yogg. He wants to be played.
Yogg is controlling the mouse.
The old gods are corrupting us. Froden is really having the time of his life looking at this board.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, Ekop puts himself on the board. And
how good is Aggro Shaman?
Well, it's pretty good when your opponent doesn't have a way to deal with Flame Wreath Faceless.
What does Froden have left?
Rogue.
Rogue.
That loses.
And
other than Rogue.
Something else.
And Druid.
They both should lose to Shaman, in theory. But the funny thing about math is that even if you have like two 40% matchups, you're still favored overall to win the series. Because it's like 40 and then it's like 40 out of 60. Even with 30 something, you probably are still favored to win the series, if I'm not wrong.
Yep.
Yeah, with above 30 you are. Because then if it's exactly 30, then it's like 30 out of 70, which puts you over the 50 threshold.
That's hilarious. You said it was the funny thing about math.
Wow. Come on, Chucky. Don't be so mean. Don't bully the non-native speakers. I would like to see you on the Romanian.
Yeah? I speak very fluent Romanian.
You must attack the math with taunt.
That was definitely more hilarious. Shaman is like way better on the coin because on the coin you can like go Totem Golem into one drop into three, and most of your free drops, excepting Feral Spirits, don't even overload you, so you can follow up with a Flame Reft Faceless. While if you're playing without a coin, if you have your best turn two play, which is Totem Golem, most of the time even your only turn to play, then your follow-up has to be another turn to play. So then it kind of gets clunky and the free drops are not that good. So Shaman is like way better on the coin.
Froden is going to hold back the prep to use next turn with the teacher. Hoping Ekop will play into prep fan here is the plan.
Tusker, get Flame Tongue.
That would be pretty good.
Taunt is also not bad.
Taunt? Yeah.
You might just ignore the SI. Nah, iterate it. Iterate it, yeah.
Yeah. Good thing about Tuskar Totemic on 3, though, is you can just curve right into Flaming Faces.
Ooh.
Oh, baby.
And before he draws a second fan of knives, that would be cool.
Ooh, sap.
Rogue is doing rogue things this game.
Yeah.
Wait, I don't know if that Prep Eviscerate was needed.
Well, it does play into Storm. So Ekop, surprisingly, I mean, Froden's kind of doing this thinking, yeah, how's Aggro Shaman ever getting back on the board against this? But, I mean, it plays pretty much perfectly into Storm Rockbiter if that's how he chooses to do it.
Yeah, you should do it.
Well, the other way to do it is just Lava Burst right now and then Storm Rockbiter, or just Storm, rather.
Yeah. As far as I'm concerned, if you Lava Burst now, you're only going to have 3 mana next turn, Chucky. I don't know how math works
that's
in
why
NA,
I said just Storm.
But, okay.
like you Lava Burst Teacher and Storm the 1-1s next turn. This way you actually just, your play next turn is now just Lava Burst, hopefully whatever he plays, yeah. Which will work out.
Sometimes you can just win this matchup by killing the minions and then dropping a threat that isn't answered because they only had minions early.
Yeah. And with both preps down, Frodan's definitely out of stuff to do.
Yeah, like Ekop's hand is much more valuable than Frodan's. He's got three big threats. I mean, two big minion threats and one big weapon threat, so.
Yeah, it's really rare you see double prep maybe be a losing draw, especially with the teacher. But yeah. Ekop basically had the perfect answer to that.
Yeah.
This is a game where both players drew perfectly. So naturally, the Shaman should win this, but anything can happen. Get it? He's playing a Morlock. Anything can happen.
Real funny.
I tried.
Ooh, Azure Drake plus Eviscerate.
He doesn't kill it, right?
He's just gonna sap.
He can poke it.
Oh, you can like... No, you don't face tank it. You trade a Thalnos in. Seven life is worth more than a Thalnos.
Hey, poke it with the Thalnos.
Yeah, yeah. Okay, he didn't specify.
He's a little guy.
Yeah, yeah.
The action of the Thanos attacking is a poke.
But you could just sap it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
He could.
Yeah.
He did.
Yeah.
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 I just figure you're not going to really have much more spell damage ever again.
What about next turn?
What if he kills your stuff?
How?
Lava Burst.
Number two?
Yeah.
Guys, what about Doomhammer, go full face, next turn play a taunt, or Ferals, go full face, and next turn play another taunt and go full face. I do not think Rogue can deal 24 damage in 3 turns through these taunts. And I think Shaman can deal the 25 with the Doomhammer and the Rockbiter being picked up right now.
So in just 3 turns alone with Doomhammer, Rockbiter, that's 18.
Yeah.
So if he's playing the taunts every turn, he needs to pick up 7 damage? That's a lot.
That's not 25, Radu.
I mean, 7 damage is doable. Do you see a better line of play here? Do you see like a better chance for him to win?
His next like two out of his next 3 cards would have to be cheap
damage
spells.
Maybe he can just kill minions. Or just replay stuff.
It just seems that you give yourself a bit more chances by going for the Doomhammer YOLO play.
Oh my goodness.
I don't know. Rogue could definitely just run out of stuff. Like, this hand would be great if Frodan had an Auctioneer, but he does not.
Does he not?
He does not.
Oh.
Wait, is this an Auctioneer? Nope. Eviscerate. Good call, Chucky.
That's what I'm here for.
Professional casters. Ellie Giggle.
Well, now he's back at the same situation he was last time. I mean, I think he just go all in here, right? Use everything.
Yeah. It looks like, you know, obviously concealing is pretty powerful. I'm wondering if he's going to hold back the Abyss. Just leave that bad boy up.
He will get uber punished by taunts.
Well, he's setting up for lethal next turn. As long as he, 9, 10... Eviscerate says 4. Yeah, he's got lethal next turn.
No, there are taunts.
Well, taunts. If you draw spirits.
Any card that's playable. Oh, no.
But there are taunts in the way.
The spirit wolves are going to go against his will.
Great role playing. Top notch. But the thing is, can Ekop set up a lethal of his own?
No.
Yeah, he has Rogue-Bitek Doomhammer. He just goes Feral Spirits, Argent Horse Rider.
Well, sure.
He'll have 7 mana next turn.
If the, you know, 7-3 doesn't die.
He can pick up a Bolt. Still not enough. He needs spell power.
Yeah, I mean, I think the play is definitely Feral Spirit, Argent Horse Rider.
Yeah. You put, like, a lot of sticky and annoying minions. You know your opponent doesn't have Fan of Knives in his hand. Mainly because he used one earlier, and he would have also used the second one if he had it.
Right.
Shadow Stev. What the heck?
Shadow Step.
What?
Shadow Step. I can use that to stab myself.
You know.
That's a play.
No, you'd use it to bring yourself back and then be able to be replayed for cheaper. It's like the opposite of Sap.
I don't want to be cheaper.
Looks like he's just dead. Unless something really nice gets picked up.
What can be picked up? Something like a what? Something like a Phantom Knife?
Shiv.
Something like a Shiv?
Shiv face. Shiv face into Phantom Knives.
That'd be lethal?
Yeah.
Yeah.
So you Shiv face into something like a Phantom Knives and you win?
Yeah.
Okay.
I think Phantom Knives, you're only out, right?
Oh.
Well,
yeah,
he has to eviscerate if he's gonna live, from what we can see.
If Shadow Step was an innervate, maybe it would have worked out.
And he gets to replay the Drake.
This makes me think, why are people not playing Miracle Druid? Why are they playing Miracle Rogue? I remember Life Coach was playing Miracle Druid back in the day.
Yeah. Well, Dan managed to navigate that turn pretty well. He had an out for lethal with the Shiv face into Phantom Knives, but this play is more consistently clears the board, and Ekop doesn't draw into what he needs.
Yeah, so
he can clear off the Azure Drake with Rockbiter, but I think he wants to save that for the Doomhammer.
Well, if he goes all face, he sets up lethal, which is like a pretty big deal. Rogue doesn't really play taunts.
You can also just Hero Power Fiend from below, Tunnel Trog, hit
face. Yeah,
but
then you don't set up lethal.
You do if one of your minions survives, which is likely.
No. Yeah.
The Rogue has two cards in the hand. He already used most of the removal spells.
Sure.
He's used both preps, one fan, both Ibis, one like, Cold Blood.
There's no neutral spells, right, Chucky? You know the neutral cards. You're the expert on the neutral cards.
TJ Sanders is crafting some new cards on stream tonight. Corrupted Seer.
It's a card!
Deals 2 damage to all non-Murloc minions?
Yeah.
6 mana?
Yeah.
It's a 2-3?
Yeah.
Yeah, I don't know. Don't know if I believe it.
Don't worry, it exists.
All right. I think there is a card like that, but nobody plays because it's so shitty.
It's pretty good.
No, it isn't.
I think it is. Imagine if it was in Frodan's deck earlier. It would have had a cleaner clear on the board.
In this situation.
This was probably my least favorite play of Ecops because it doesn't set up lethal even if everything survives.
Yeah, but he's trying to play the War of Attrition.
That's a risky war to play. I feel like if Frodan picked up a spell.
Which are none because he used all most of his spells. Again, there are no neutral spells, Chucky, as far as I'm concerned.
Yeah.
It doesn't matter if they're neutral or class. All that matters is if they're in the deck, Radu.
Like, what can he have? He used most of his spells.
Yeah, he still has a backstab. He still has a fan of magic.
Okay, and that is not going to clear a 5-5.
A Shadow Strike.
Explain yourself, Chucky.
Shadow Strike.
Does he run that too? I don't think he can run that with Chief. Checkmate what? Come on, Chucky. Don't be childish.
Well, now Frodan's trying to go on the grind out plan, but Doomhammer will probably put a stop to that.
Yeah, they're both trying to grind each other down.
Capital Pride.
Abusive is a decent pickup, allows him to clean betray the Farseer, the Earthen Ring Farseer.
Mm. Well done. Get in there and fight, maggot. And yeah, Frodan basically has nothing.
Well, apparently he has no spells left, which I would tend to disagree with, TJ.
He has very little spells remaining.
Very few.
Checkmate.
How could you say that's right, RDU?
Welcome to grammar lessons, TJ.
That sentence definitely had taunt. Yeah,
it's not a spell. I guess RDU was right.
I mean, I didn't say he has no spells. I said he has very few, not little.
No,
few.
You said he had no spells. I said he had very little.
Well, RDU kept hammering this point about there being no neutral spells. I don't know.
All right, well, Ecop ties it up 2-2. That means we're going to a game number 5. What the rest of his niggas do? And that means we get to cast one more game.
Ikop seems like he's not that relaxed.
Why would you be?
Yeah, you're playing for your tournament life right now. He went down 2-0.
He's praying to Yogg.
Doesn't even have Yogg in his deck.
Yeah.
He's praying to Frodan's Yogg.
That is bad. Because Frodan's last deck is going to be Druid.
Oh, boy.
Is that the only one hearing that music?
I hope the stream heard
crazy?
That. Little biggie before we get into game 5.
At first, I thought that music was like the musical version of Corrupted Seer, but...
It's Biggie Yogg.
Yeah. That's the game number 5 music.
All right, this is pretty gross hand from Frodan.
I don't... What? Did he already mulligan?
Yeah.
It's a bit counterintuitive.
I don't like it.
Like, if you play the Emperor this early with nothing in your hand or very few cards in your hand, then even though you get a cost reduction, you don't maximize the efficiency and you mostly just double innervate out a body, a 5-5 body.
I'm hearing it again, man.
Are we going insane? Or... I don't know.
Okay, well, that's a lot of ramp, but just
it's
about...
It's too much now.
But very few substance.
What? No, stop!
Is that correct grammar, Jackie?
No! It's about as correct as Corrupted Seer. I'm going to keep drilling this home until TJ honestly believes Corrupted Seer is not a Hearthstone card.
He's thinking of turn one Emperor. What do you think of that?
Sometimes you gotta...
How deep is it?
Play the hand that's dealt to you, man.
It's funny that if he plays it, he's actually gonna get super wrecked by a cop.
It's good against Totem Golem, whereas like if you just go slow, you kind of get wrecked just by minions. Whereas the Emperor gets wrecked by spells.
No balls.
It definitely reveals kind of what sort of cards he has in his hand when he ropes out a turn one Living Roots.
Yeah. But no Totem Golem. Strong turn two play, so Dan's got to be feeling pretty happy about that one. And another cheap card. Is that what you want to see?
Yeah.
Now he can play Innervate, Coin, Emperor, Living Roots. It's a bit too much. But again, like Emperor is not like the best card to Innervate out most of the time. To double Innervate out, excuse me.
Yeah.
It's not really the best combination.
The way that Dan set that up, it's... I don't know, it doesn't really telegraph anything.
Yeah.
Because Ecop saw that he was hovering over cards, so there's probably Innervates in there somewhere. Might be thinking about Swipe, but what's the strongest play you can make this turn? That plays around... Maybe he is worried about Swipe.
Argent Square, Hero Power?
Yeah, if you're worried about Swipe, you just put out some weak stuff. You don't throw out like a valuable target like Flame Tongue. But if you get Swiped and can just slam down Flame Reef Faceless, like that's not too bad.
I like Argent Square Totem.
Okay, let's think of it this way. If Ekop is insane at Hearthstone, which he can be, because he made the play, he could make the read that Frodan has 2 Innervates, he knows he has a coin, he can make a read that he has a card that he doesn't want to Innervate, maybe an Emperor Taurisson, something like an Emperor Taurisson, and then opts to play the Flame Tongue Totem to push as much damage as possible. What do you think about that?
Wow. That's pretty next level.
Yeah, maybe Ekop did it. Like... Why not? You have a lot of time. They both roped.
Yeah.
What else can you be thinking of? You try to like pitch down the cards that your opponent has in his hand.
Yeah, and it was something like double innervate Thorison.
Yeah, but whoa. What is this?
This is probably Lightning Bolt, trade in the Squire, and develop a Tuskar Totemic.
Why not Flame Wreath Faces and then Tuskar next turn?
It's, you have four mana.
Flame Mage trade, trade.
What?
Well, this play just kind of safer.
Oh, well, if you're going to get a Totem Golem.
Yeah, that's pretty sick.
Yeah.
It's not as sick as what Thais did earlier on the B-Stream. For those of you that didn't watch, he rolled four Totem Golems out of four Tuskers against Hoi. And it's the first time I saw Hoi being on tilt on a Hearthstone stream.
Yeah, Hoi didn't have his bird with him.
If he played the Flame Wreath, Spell Power Swipe would have been a punish.
He would have traded into the Astro Drake.
Would he? Yeah. Throw away your Trog?
Yeah.
No way.
Yeah. Wow. I mean, what if you get an inconsequential totem? What if you get like a healing totem?
Your board it heals your Trog. That's what if, TJ.
What if you got a Searing Totem?
It's a 1-1.
Yeah, but that's not good.
Don't be rude to Searing Totem.
Okay, I guess a lot of the outcomes with Tuskar Totemic were good.
It's just kind of the safer play. You can always Flame Wreath next turn.
Yeah.
Wait, why is Frodan getting the free one over the Trog?
Maybe he's not aware of the card text.
Or maybe he figured that Flame Wreath Faceless would have been a much better play last turn if he had had it. So he wasn't expecting Ecop to have it.
Okay, what? So now, if we assume that they both went next level,
I like
what
my story.
What do you think is the chance of Ecop not playing Flame Red Faceless to make Frodan think he doesn't have it, so that Frodan makes a play that is weak to Flame Red Faceless, and then Ecop proceeds into playing the Flame Red Faceless to put Frodan in a bad situation?
Wow.
I could have said that faster.
You're gonna
get another Reddit video. Shit. I had to like learn how to pronounce it Flame Ref Faceless faster and
just
wrap it up.
Say it really fast right now.
Flame Ref Faceless.
Now faster every time you say
it. I cannot do that.
Five times in a row.
Can you do it?
No. Flame I'm asking you to do
okay.
it.
Okay. Flame Ref Faceless. Flame Ref Faceless. Fuck.
Fine.
I cannot do it.
That's actually the abbreviated version of Flame Ref Faceless. You didn't know?
That's what your opponent says when you play it.
If you play Hearthstone on like 20 times speed. Oh, Flame Ref Faceless doesn't say his name when he spawned. Never mind. I take that back.
What does he say? No, that's not what he says. He says like,
I dream and the world trembles.
No. Totem Golem goes,
okay, that's the noise I had in my head. Google it.
I mean, I know the noise. I just don't know what to say.
What does it sound? What does the noise sound like?
It's like Fender Lights. I feel like a Pokemon, man.
Well, Flame Red Face is going to stick.
And hit the face.
Wow, he's already at 9? I didn't even see that.
Yeah.
Well, what does Frodan do here? He's got to kill the Flame Red Faceless, so he has to
swipe.
Trade, swipe, and then Hero Power down the Totem Golem?
Gross.
He can buff both, swipe, and then trade the 3-3 and trade the 4-4 into the 3-3.
Yep.
And he'll end up with the 4-1 and Ecop is going to have just the totem. This is still a close game. Frodan can win if he gets a taunt. Or Yogg.
Yeah, but Yogg's still two turns away.
You got to praise.
Yeah, you got to start praying.
Yeah. Wow, Sir Finley Murgleton's actually a sick pickup. He can get Life Tap or Steady Shot.
Yep.
Both and great.
It looks like he's not going to totem in case he gets Life Tap.
Yeah. It's usually a safe bet.
Oh, he gets the Life Tap.
Rewarded?
Rewarded, indeed.
I mean, he might, yeah.
Why is he thinking now? Like, that's the only reason why you don't hero power, because he might get
not rewarded.
Not
missed
rewarded.
A totem. Lol.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Twist shot. Go ham on Echo.
I think it's worth the risk, though.
Unleash the twist shot.
We'll just have to see if a totem would have won him this game.
Yeah.
What do you think about ramping here instead of the Thorsen? I don't know if a 5-5 is much better than a 3-3. But I do think being at 10 mana is pretty relevant.
Yeah, I mean, if he draws Yogg next turn, then it would have been better, maybe.
And you scare your opponent. You kind of telegraph your last card is Yogg.
That's true. That's very true.
So I mean, maybe they don't extend as much, which you don't want them to do. You want them to hold back because you don't have Yogg.
That's a good point.
Whereas now, I don't know, this sort of telegraphs it too, because it would have reduced the Yogg in his hand down to 9.
Yeah.
So, sort of similar thinking here.
It's not quite as obvious, but
yeah.
I mean, I guess just the more power on the board.
Actually, this one acts like your last card is Yogg better, I think, whereas the other one kind of, you could read it as he's hoping to top deck Yogg.
Ekop is not sure if he should play the Flame Ref Faceless. He's really afraid of Yogg.
Yeah.
I think he was just thinking if he ever taps here. Yeah.
Nah,
but
he don't tap.
He's going to go max power, and there's not
really... Yeah, he expects the Yogg.
Oh, okay. Well, he can Ancient of War into Yogg.
That will save him for now.
He actually expected the Yogg. Look at Ekop's camera. Yeah. Rodan got in his mind. Too bad he cannot abuse that.
I'll think more. From below. That's not going to win him the game.
And he cannot tap and play both cards from his hand. I think it's just Lightning Storm.
I guess you have to.
You need to high roll on one.
Yeah.
If you low roll on both, you have to trade your Feral Spirit too.
All right. Well, then it might be... I don't know. Frodo needs the best draws, and he does roll high on...
Okay, well...
One of them.
Now we need the Yogg or another taunt?
Yeah.
Come on, Yogg. 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 Yogg.
Nah.
That's game.
Well,
and Ekop completes the reverse sweep on Frodan with the aggressive Shaman.
Yeah, and Frodan's tournament run has come to an end. Throws out the well-played.
Flame Rift Faceless is pretty good.
Yeah. He
Look at Ekop.
Bumps.
Very happy.
Yeah, I don't think Frodan can be disappointed with his tournament performance, though.
Yeah?
Went to the Group of Death yesterday.
Bulk chop.
Bog Champ did work.
But Ekop seems thrilled.
Ekop is the victor today.
Next game is going to be Ekop versus Borat, right?
Yeah. Yeah. All right, make room for the Ekop here.
Come on in.
Is that going to reach? Yeah, it'll reach. Hey, man.
Damn, it's so loud in here. What the hell?
Yeah. They're cheering for you.
Yeah, I heard.
Yeah. So you completed the reverse sweep. With Azure
again.
Shaman.
Against the Tempest Storm member. Again.
Wow. That's pretty brutal for Tempest Storm.
How much did you praise the Yogg?
How much did I pray against Yogg, you mean?
Yeah.
It's like, please, no Yogg.
Did you think he had Yogg at the end when he played Emperor?
Of course. It was like, yeah, he's got to have it.
Yeah.
Here we go.
His last card was like Mire Keeper, I think, or something like that.
Yeah, it felt good to not see Yogg.
Yeah.
That's for sure. I mean, if you've seen those series, my Yogg's work. Like, my series against Frodan and against Nyman, my Yoggs were kind of underwhelming.
Yeah.
Well, enemy Yoggs. Kind of good, but hey, that's how it just goes sometimes.
Yeah.
So, instead I get some fish, you know?
Yeah.
Totem Golem.
Totem Golem, there you go. Well, you're still chugging along pretty well, man. Just one more win and you're into the top 8. You got to go up against...
Nyman again.
Nyman again, yeah. So, how are you feeling going into that match? Because the last one ended sort of... Sort of weird. It was a close series.
It was a super close series.
Yeah.
And it's probably going to be another close series. But it can go either way, as you have seen.
Yeah.
I think I can do this.
Yeah, well, a lot of people were saying that they were scared of Frodan.
So was I. That Bog Champ Shaman, man, I had to ban it.
Yeah.
but it's weird because, I know this deck, but Bog Champ Shaman is... potentially very good against my lineup.
Mm.
So I kind of wanted to ban it. But then again, I didn't know what his warrior deck was because he didn't play it all week.
Yeah.
So it could have been anything. So I just had to, YOLO it pretty much. In Kitsune Warrior, it was kind of hard. But I managed to pull it off in the end with the Aggro Shaman.
Yeah.
Was hard. He probably got a pretty bad draw against the Shaman with the C'Thun Warrior.
He had like double Ancient Shield Bearer, Doom Caller, and C'Thun.
Yeah,
something like that.
Yeah, so. I figured. Like, he has to draw pretty poorly in order to lose against Face Shaman with Lightning Storm. So.
Well, he did, and you slayed the Frodan. So, I know a lot of people in the tournament are going to be happy because they don't have to face the Shaman anymore. But you're going to be an enemy among all the Frodan fans out there.
I'm sorry to all the Frodan fans. Hope you take this apology. Wow.
You can become an Akop fan now.
Yeah, sure. Yeah. Why not?
Akop can win without getting a good Yogg. That's a reason.
Sometimes lucky, even though unlucky.
Yeah. You guys have any more questions for Akop?
Yeah.
You do?
Are you aware of the existence of a card called Corrupted Seer?
Corrupted Seer.
Is that a no?
Both quiz.
It is the Murloc 6 mana 2/3.
Correct. It exists! Yeah, that's correct.
Yeah, I heard of that card.
Deals 2 damage to non-Murloc minions.
Yeah.
Damn it.
All non-Murloc minions.
Yeah, all non-Murloc minions, yeah.
I wanted to point out, Chucky downstairs in the players area said something to me, which kind of came true here. Mm-hmm. He was like, don't get memed, meme yourself.
That's very philosophical.
I don't recall saying that.
Yeah.
Somebody, please make a picture of Chucky with the coat.
And... that's pretty much what happened, right? Like, I didn't really get memed, but I memed myself with my own Yogg, so...
Yeah.
Sure.
Wise words from Chucky.
I didn't say those words.
Then who did?
You did.
I don't know.
It sounds like something you would say.
Maybe somebody in your head, Jacob.
Yeah, maybe.
Maybe you heard a voice.
The voice
that's
in my
why
head.
He thinks Corrupted Seer exists.
You look Chucky in the eyes, and his mouth didn't even move, but you heard his voice in your head.
It all adds up.
Don't get memed. Meme yourself. And congratulations, Akop. We'll let you prep for your next match, because it's going to be the next one. That's going to be the last one.
Yeah, you play now.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
No rest for the weary.
Get back in there.
Ekop versus Naaman. So, more Seatsuri Cup, last match of the day coming up.